Hello and welcome back, folks, to the Week in 7 Questions, today with Eoin Drea from the Martin Centre. First, Eoin, is the end of the corona crisis near? Can we expect the economic growth we were promised for Q2 of this year?
Unfortunately, we're not there yet. Lockdowns and other restrictions will last throughout quarter two. The best case scenario at the moment is that the level of vaccinations will speed up dramatically in the coming months, allowing a partial return to growth from July or August. But even that is far from guaranteed.
Being essential for many EU member states, tourism depends to a great extent on the success of the vaccination passport. Do you think this could become reality for the beginning of summer holidays?
I think it will have to become a reality if the EU is serious about helping more tourism-dependent economies like Portugal, Spain and Greece. Should the EU fail in this proposal, I think what will happen is that more bilateral deals between individual member states will take hold. And that's not a very good look for an EU desperate to show some solidarity.
How big an impact will the EU Recovery Fund have in 2021? Will it bring back the millions of jobs lost?
It's going to have very little impact in 2021. I think one of the big mistakes that the EU has made has been to try and sell the recovery fund as a short-term tool for regeneration. But as we've already seen, disagreements between the Commission and member states are multiplying almost daily. The recovery fund might create jobs in 2022 and 2023, but very few in 2021.
Now that public debt in Europe has skyrocketed, so after the pandemic, are we going towards a new phase of budget restrictions and austerity again?
Well, I think such a move would be absolutely disastrous for the EU. Thankfully, it seems that at least some of the lessons of the financial crisis have been learned. EU fiscal rules will probably stay suspended until the end of 2022 at the earliest. But really, what's needed in the long term is a full-scale review of EU fiscal rules and how we manage European Monetary Union.
This crisis deepened the major inequalities in our societies, such as rich-poor, men, women, north-south, etc. With you among them, some economists propose a reform towards tax individualization. Could you briefly explain this to our viewers?
Sure. Well, most countries have tax systems where married couples are taxed jointly. That generally means that the lower earning partner, often the woman, pays proportionally more tax than the higher earning partner. Tax individualization, on the other hand, taxes couples individually, regardless of their levels of earnings. The argument is that this can promote greater equality, create jobs, and boost economic growth. Although it must be acknowledged that there are significant political costs and that some sections of the population will be worse off.
What can be expected, in your opinion, from the Euro summit at the end of the month?
To be honest, very little. I think we're going to have lots of talk about supporting the recovery and speeding up vaccinations. We're going to have lots of very nice Twitter threads and some promotional videos, but they won't be in a position to announce any significant breakthrough or acceleration of the economic recovery.
Finally, this week, Irish people celebrated their biggest festivity, Happy St. Patrick's Day. What was your most important prayer to him this year?
Well, basically just that as St. Patrick banished all the snakes from Ireland, that the EU should now use the pandemic to rid itself of its desire for more integration across every subject area. We need a leaner, meaner, more efficient EU. Unfortunately, what we have at the moment isn't that.
Thank you, Eoin. Thanks, everyone, for watching, and see you again next week for another Week in 7 Questions with another surprise guest.